Today we are gonna talk about what is an inverse of a function. Alright, so let's say we have two sets A and B, and now consider a one-to-one correspondence or a bijection from set A to set B. Okay, now we know that when F is a bijection or a one-to-one correspondence, we know two things. F is onto, meaning every element of the set B is the image of some element in A. Alright, now we also know F is 1 to 1. So which meaning that every element of B is the image of a unique element of A. Right, so because F is a 1 to 1 correspondence, F is both onto and 1 to 1. In this case, we are telling that we can define a new function. A new function from set B to set A that is gonna reverse the correspondence given by the function f. Okay, and that new function is nothing but the inverse of a function written as f inverse from set B to set A. When f is a one-to-one correspondence from set A to set B, the inverse function of f is a function that assigns to an element B belonging to the set capital B the unique element small a in capital A such that f of a equal to b. The inverse function of f is denoted by f raised to minus 1, and hence when f of a equal to b, f inverse of b equal to a. A one-to-one correspondence is called invertible because we can define an inverse of this function. Alright, a function is not invertible if it is not a one-to-one correspondence. Before going to that point, let's illustrate the inverse of a function through a diagram. F is the function from set A to set B, and that's why the element small a in the set capital A is mapped to the element small b in capital B by the function f. So f of a equal to b. Now f inverse is going to map the element small a in capital A to the element small b in capital B, meaning f inverse is from set B to set A, and the element small b in capital B is assigned the value small a in capital A, meaning f inverse of b equal to a. Alright, and we have to note that f inverse f, or when we denote f raised to minus 1, it is different from 1 by f. So 1 by f of x is another function which is different from inverse of the function. Let's get to the point that if a function f is not a bijection or a one-to-one correspondence, we cannot define an inverse of this function. Why? If f is not a bijection, we know that either it is not one-to-one or it is not onto, right? So either of these cases will happen. Now suppose if the function f is not a one-to-one function, then meaning that some element small b in the codomain is the image of more than one element in the domain. When f is not a one-to-one function, we can't define f inverse. Why? So f is a function from set A to set B, right? Now given that f is not one-to-one, meaning that more than one element in the set A has mapped to an element in the set B. Now let's say we are trying to define an inverse of this function, right, by mapping the elements of set B to set A. Now we already know that more than one element in the set A has been mapped to an element in the set B. Now for that element, how we will map? We can't have a function where we assign more than one value to any element, right? And that's why we can't define an inverse of the function here. Now similar case with when f is onto. When f is onto, we know that the range is not same as the codomain, meaning that so when f is a function from set A to set B, now the range of f is not same as the set B, meaning that some elements in the set B doesn't have a preimage, right? So if they doesn't have a preimage, when we try to reverse map from f inverse from B to A, when we try to do that, we can't even assign an element for that elements, right, in the set B. So if we can't assign an element for an element in the set, then we can't define a function, right? That's not a function. And that's why when f is not a bijection, f inverse, the inverse of a function, we can't define. Now let's see some examples. Okay, so let f be the function from set a comma b comma c to set 1 comma 2 comma 3 such that f of a equal to 2, f of b equal to 3 and f of c equal to 1. Now the question is f invertible, and if it is, what is its inverse? Function f is invertible because it is a one-to-one correspondence. Now it is a one-to-one correspondence because it is both one-to-one and onto, right? Now the function is invertible, we should define the inverse function, right? The inverse function is defined this way: because f of c equal to 1, f inverse of 1 equal to c, and because f of a equal to 2, f inverse of 2 equal to a, and because f of b equal to 3, f inverse of 3 equal to b. Okay, so let f from set of integers to set of integers be a function such that f of x equal to x plus 1. Now the question is f invertible? And if it is, what is f inverse? The answer is that it is invertible because f is a one-to-one correspondence. We have already seen this in our previous videos. We have already proved that f of x equal to x plus 1, where f is from set to set, is both one-to-one and onto, right? Now we have to find what is f inverse. So suppose that y is the image of the element x, okay? Now which meaning that x plus 1 equal to y, right? Because f of x equal to y and f of x equal to x plus 1 equal to y. From that we get x is y minus 1, right? So now y minus 1 has been mapped to an element y, right? The function f, maps the element y minus 1 to the element y. Now when we try to reverse map, f inverse of y becomes y minus 1. That's the inverse function, okay? Let f be the function from set of real numbers to set of real numbers with f of x equal to x square. Now the question is f invertible? Now the answer is that it is not. It is not invertible because f is not a bijection. Okay, f is not bijection because we can prove that f is not one to one. Now f is not one to one because if you see f of 2 and f of minus 2, both are having the values 4. So the element 2 and the element minus 2 has been mapped to the element 4. Alright, so that is not a one-to-one function. And now whenever you try to reverse map this function, what we will get, we'll have to assign two values to the element 4, and that can't be done, and that's not a function. That's why f is not invertible. Alright, in the next lecture we will see about composition of functions and some other important functions, and soon we will see about what is countable set and what is an uncountable set. So if you have not subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe to the channel for getting the notifications. Okay, thank you.